For years, the only vampires that I knew were the ones played by Bela Lugosi, Max Schreck, and Christopher Lee. Dracula and Nosferatu would accompany me as I drifted off into sleep, and I would have nightmares of death on dark wings, glistening fangs, and torrents of blood. Awake! And I would toddle down the stairs for breakfast and stare terror-struck at my bowl of Count Chocula cereal. My mask skills were savaged by my fear of the Count from Sesame Street, but I still watched the movies and read the books, and with age, my fear turned into desire, and I thirsted to be a creature of the night, to exist in the shadow of life and to never die. I met those who shared my dark fantasies, and we would gather under the full moon, drink the reddest of drinks, wear the blackest of clothes, and dance to the darkest of music. There, I met a beautiful shade, my divine nightmare. She gave me a book and told me to devour it. It will change your life. So I read it, and I have but one thing to say. Anne Rice, you bitch! Thanks to you, I no longer want the gift of eternal life, because from what I've gathered of your books, to be a vampire means I must also transform into a whiny, narcissistic dandy. It was once that Dracula could raise the hair on the back of your neck with a simple, I never drink wine. Today, we're subjected to 40 pages of excessive detail on how Louis doesn't drink wine anymore because it reminds him of the last glass of wine he had before he accepted the embrace of Lestat. Blah, 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 Louis. You're either a beast or you're not. And if you got a problem with taking nourishment from the living, here's my advice. Wake up early and don't hit that snooze alarm. Louis, meet Mr. Sun. You know, Nosferatu was never filled with existentialist dread about living forever, yet to hear the modern vampire talk about immortality, it makes me want to suggest that they only drink the blood of people taking some serious antidepressants. I mean, vampires used to have presence. They could walk into a room and with a single unblinking stare, you would know terror. Now, I would just like to see one movie where the vampire doesn't make itself known by pulling his cape back, hissing loudly, baring his fangs. I still dream of vampires, though. But my dreams have become nightmares again. They're no longer crimson showers and switchblade smiles. Now I'm trapped in a room of vampires, and I'm trying to get them to shut the hell up.